wrote the book so that it would support one chapter, one lecture.
Okay.
And so that gives you a strong understanding of why the front end is like, you're like, oh my goodness, four chapters to get through principle, supply, demand, and equilibrium.
And one lecture is how many minutes?
So for me, it's 8.
Oh.
And then you have 14 weeks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we have a long, Michigan goes forever, your campus may not, which is why then it's a choose your own adventure.
Yeah.
But like the front end is those four chapters, because when I talk to instructors, they're like, I spend four classes.
Yeah.
Some spend six. No one says one chapter, read chapter one today, and we'll have supply, demand, and equilibrium done on Monday. So on Wednesday, we can move on to the late market. So kind of, you know, the students might be like, that many more pages, but it's because that's actually the spacing of the semester. And then if you have like shorter lectures, you'll notice each chapter is set up as like four mini episodes, typically four. And so you might choose three episodes or two episodes or something like that. And so then the front end of the book is, you know, here's the foundations of economics. Then there's applications of it to public policy and ongoing policy issues. So this is labor markets. For some students, they're really into inequality. Other instructors really want to teach trade. And so that's a run of chapters. Then particularly for the business students, there's a run of chapters about business strategy, which is our reworking of what used to be the old four market models. And so, you know, some instructors will go heavy there. And for those of us, and I actually really do, I love teaching game theory, which everyone always says you can't do to principal students. I love teaching imperfect information. And so that's sort of there as well. If you want to be ambitious, you pull those chapters in. If you don't think they work, there's plenty to do.
I really love teaching imperfect information because I think it buys a lot of credibility with the students. Because they think the world is imperfectly informed. I was going to say, you know, our teaching did inform a lot of the design of the book. So you might, we have two chapters on labor. Now you might think that's because I was chief economist at the Department of Labor and I'm a labor economist. It's actually because I couldn't get through all the material in one lecture. And when I couldn't get through all the material in one lecture, I was like, you can't either. So let's split it into two. You don't have to teach, if you're like, I'm not doing two lectures on labor, I'm not a labor person, then you can teach the first one, which is the meat and potatoes, and then all the stuff that I felt like I couldn't, you know, exclude because it's so important is in a second chapter. So that's that commitment to one. A chapter should be like reasonably digestible in a 80-minute lecture.